Thank you, Dan. Up next, we will see how NextMed Malaysia products are being used in infrastructure. Can we have Mr. Kong Hin-Yu from JP Survey to present?
Space and air, and over the land and sea. That's basically what we do. Alright, some of our offices in different states in Malaysia. Now come to the actual infrastructure development division in the company. We actually provide data and services to satisfy the infrastructure development projects. We're dealing a lot with the roads, engineer, developers. So basically like what Ben mentioned earlier today, all the engineer wants is a hole. No point asking them to buy a drill. And then a lot of them don't really care how you make the hole. As long as the hole and the size and the depth are all correct. So we are the one doing all this work for the engineers. Right? So for all the infrastructure development projects, break down to many phases. At the beginning, the feasibility study stage, planning, preliminary design. These are the three stages that we involve in providing data using satellite, using IFSA, and all that. Of course, later on, in the development stages, the land matters, detail design, and the construction phase, we have our land surveying division at the end. Now, come to the typical data set. What do we provide to engineers? First thing, of course, the satellite images. We normally use the 1 meter or better resolution. That will provide them the detailed land cover in the form of XY. Of course, they will also need to have the third dimension, that is the height. And this height will normally in the form of contour or DTM. And all this had to be complemented with some cadastral logs information. That is a piece of information for the engineer to estimate the land cooking costs and what some of the existing development and things like that. So very typically we are supplying them these three layers of information. Now how is IFSA being used in our projects? As you all know, IFSA already has an XY accuracy of about 2 meters. So because of that, we actually use it to extract control points from the OE. Because a lot of the lower accuracy is a black image. By using this control point is good enough in many cases to improve the geometry. And of course, by using ORI to extract the control point, it saves a lot of time and money compared to sending the surveyor down to the ground and survey those points. I would say now more than 70% of all the images and control points are extracted from ORI. The next important thing about using the ISFA is the ESM. Use DSM to auto-rectify all the satellite images. Because we are giving to engineers who emphasize a lot on accuracy. So all images need to be auto-rectified so that problem like this, the mismatch of the image with the cadastral logs, will be improved. On the left is the image before the auto-rectification. And the cadastral logs are actually punching from the certified plan, so very accurate variation. You see a big difference there. And after auto-rectified, all the thing matches very nicely. Next will be the control. Like I say, a lot of engineers are still prefer to work on the control in the cache environment. So we still extract, so then the control enhance a little bit by doing some stereo editing in the office, put in some extra grid lines to improve the control. And then after that, they can use it as an image map. We occasionally we also use the IFSA-TM to generate the slope map. In this particular example, we use the you have to generate a slope map so that they can identify the area with very steep slope to avoid a certain type of development. And the next one, very interesting application will be the ORI. Some of the presenters earlier mentioned that cloud is the number one enemy in the satellite image, I mean, in this part of the world. I haven't seen for the past 10 years a single project without cloud cover problem. And when ORI comes in, it's like I said, we use it quite a lot. On the left, you see the cloud. On the right, we patch it up using the ORI. Let us zoom in. Well, you still see the difference, but again, the features are there. Do some color improvement so that it matches the surrounding. Not only cosmetic improvement, the actual features on the ground, you will not be covered by the ground, you will be able to see it. And this is especially important to road engineers and things like that. They try to avoid certain development when they try to propose a route for a new highway, for example. So we do that. Whenever the project involves ISA, we will use the ORI to patch over it and give them a cloud-free image throughout. Of course, sometimes for easy interpretation, we also do some color ORI or patch over ORI. This is the ORI over Tower of Land. It's very high resolution. See a lot of details, but you can't really tell which area is actually covered by vegetation, which area is actually bare earth. So we normally would buy some very low cost spot color image, for example, the 10 meter spot. Because it's color, and then do a pen sharpening of the ORI. So with this color ORI, you'll be able to tell exactly where is the station, where is the barren land, where are the houses and all that. Right, you do a comparison on the left with a color version, on the right is the black and white version. Then you use the product called the 3D visualization. Because in most projects, you will always encourage the customer to buy the image and also the design. So these two are the major components as far as cost is concerned. And they already have these two data sets. So we would normally generate a 3D visualization for them at a very little extra. Right. So based on that, this is a project we did for Science Army. Not only they can see the terrain, they know where the boundary of the properties. They also use this to present to potential investors, showing them all the facilities and all the infrastructure near the development area. This is very near to Kiao Ai Vision, which is at the farm end. So we do this for a lot of the developer, a lot of the road engineers, because once they have narrowed down the corridor of the proposed road, we normally do a 3D visualization for them to present to the board, to present to the higher authority for approval. Right. So basically this is what we do. We also annotate names and also the height. You see some of the spot height. The height is actually extracted directly from the ASR. So they have a very realistic terrain feeling and also the spot height, give them a feeling how the terrain is. Right. So I'm going to show you a few samples which is a little bit more interesting than the normal one. We did one, in fact this is one of the first projects that we used IFSAR back in 2009 when it was first available over SAPA. We produced this image over the area over KK for a dam site. And then because of the time limitation, they need to have a terrain very quickly. So we suggested IFSAR at the time without any experience dealing with IFSAR, we want the first order. We process it and very quickly they do a simulation of the this is actually the dam location here and do a the limits of the proposed dam. You see a lot of this funny jagged edge because at the beginning they do not know how to use it. So by the time they actually have confidence in the data, they buy a little bit more here, a little more there. So you see all the funny jagged edge there. So at the end, it helps them. But it doesn't replace the actual ground survey because they still went back to the ground to survey some section to improve on the heights. But that is a very important tool for them to limit the limited time available. Right? This is one of the dam sites that we need. And we do a lot of highways, but this is one of the 80 kilometers of highway from Kimara to Damansara, proposed highway. Again, image at the backdrop, we purchase the IFSAR, we auto-rectify the image, we provide the contour for the engineers. Then they select the route. Once they selected the route, because at the time the image was a little bit outdated, about 1.5, 2 years old, we did a new aerial photography over the selected roads, and then we did the 3D visualization for them. This is the double track project from Gemas to Johor Bahru. The engineer used this product image contour with the pedestrian loss to realign certain section of the existing railway. You have to build a second track parallel to the first one. So certain sections need to be realigned. So with this, they can optimize the bridge crossing, the avoid development, and look at the terrain, design the suitable profiles of the new track. This is a a project we did for a town plan over Penang Hill. It's a small area, but interesting is that they actually use this not only the image and the contour and the loss, they also get the slope map down. So with this, you know, Penang Hill is always a point for argument as far as pipeline, Subang Samaraju, Amirway. They actually, project was already underway, they were building the pipes. But one section of the terminal was so steep that they had difficulties laying the pipes. They want to find an alternative route. But they have limitations because the pipe already replicated and they cannot go beyond the contracted length of pipe. So it becomes a challenging task. Within a short period of time, the IFSAR is the only available data they can use. So with the image of the backdrop, IFSAR on top, and then they realign the map. All the yellow points are the IP of the pipeline. Okay? This Lahad Datu Airport in Sabah started off just a normal project providing image, data, contour, auto-rectifier. But later on, because of the complexity of the study, they actually need a lot more information. And thanks to the IFSA, we will be able to do that for them. Okay, if you know, Lahad Datu is about 20 kilometers east, and this is the coastline. It's a proposed runway. It's a funnel for the landing and the approach, pickoff and approach. So we provide the contour. So they will realign the direction of the runway to avoid there's a hill, in fact, here. Originally, the pointing was this way. Once they look at the IFSAR, they say that hill is not good. The string the bearing of it. And then there are some environmental sensitive area here. I was told that a lot of these long nose monkeys are up there. So they try not to disturb the monkeys. Not only that, they gave us this spec for the funnels. So they want us to do an obstruction mapping. What are the things that may interfere in the landing or the takeoff of the plane? Very roughly, we intersect the ESM with the slope surface of the funnel. We determine some potential obstruction. And then from there, we send our field crew down because those are the higher ground. And in fact, we do find some towers and some obstructions.